I believe it was the first year they had tried this, and I'm not sure how long they continued the experiment. But they called us the honor section, and this just meant that the 20 of us took all our classes together, while other students would tend to mix. I don't think the other students all spent Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday the same as the same hours like we did, and the classes that I had then I think they challenged us a little more too than they challenged the other students perhaps. Still, I had time to do, to work on the school paper, and to one of the important issues of going to CASE at that time was to join a fraternity. Most of the interesting action on campus would be centered around the fraternity system, and. So I pledged a fraternity also in my freshman year, I guess I can say more about that. But I had mentioned that during the spring of my freshman year is when my Mad Magazine article came out, you know, and so that well. That led later to, later on, I was editor of a magazine that we founded at CASE called Engineering and Science Review, which wrote about topics in science, and I wrote an article about Potrzebie System for that publication. I was in the music. I was in the basketball. I was manager of the basketball team at CASE, and say a few words about that because after I got into computers later on, I combined that with my work managing the basketball team. So I devised a strange formula that I don't believe in much anymore, but I had it at the time, where you could compute each basketball player's real contribution to the game, not just the points that he made, the baskets that he made, but really taking everything into account. So, for example, if you have possession of the ball in basketball, this is worth something. In fact, when you're watching a basketball game, if you sort of add one point to the score of the team who has the ball, that sort of gives a more fair indication of what the real score is of the game. So possession of the ball is worth maybe one point. You can work it out though after the game. You can say really how many times. When you had possession of the ball, did you really turn over and fumble it, or how many points did you really get during that series? And so you can work out that it may be worth only 7/10 of a point or something like this. But anyway, possession of the ball is worth something. So if you fumble, then you've lost your team 1 point or 7/10 of a point. So that's a minus something for you. If you steal the ball, if you recover a fumble, your team gained possession, so you get credit for stealing the ball. If you make a basket, in those days it was only 2 points. You don't have the 3-point shots in those days, but okay, make a basket, you get 2 points, but your team also loses possession. The other team gets possession, so you didn't really win 2 points for your team when you made the basket. You made two points, but you have to subtract from that the fact that you have to get the ball again. So at the end, according to my formula, the sum of all the players' contributions would be the amount of by which our team won or lost. But it would rate you know, somebody makes a shot and misses, then sometimes our team gets the rebound, sometimes the other team gets the rebound. So you lose a little bit for taking a shot and missing. So I calculated a huge number of statistics for every player, and I had a spotter who would call to me, and I could write it down and every little thing. And after the game, I would go and punch cards that recorded all these statistics and fed them into a little computer program that calculated the formula and made a list for every player what their real contribution to the game was, and not just their field goals and all these traditional statistics. So Case's coach, Nip Heim, loved this system, he posted these numbers, the Case News Service was always good at trying to plant interesting stories in the local paper, so they sent reporters out told about this formula, and IBM heard about it. And so IBM sent out a camera crew to make a film of me spotting a game, you know, in our Case team playing basketball, of course, things, but then how I would punch the cards, you know, and put it into the IBM computer. Before they took the shot of the IBM computer, they planted a great big IBM sign on the machine, so that nobody could fail to miss it. You know that I was doing this, and then I'm turning the buttons on the console, and getting the numbers out, and it's getting printed out on their IBM printer, and then the coach is looking at it and posting this out. So this was a little movie that I was in, about 2 or 3 minutes long. IBM supplies this movie to CBS, and they put it on the Sunday evening news with Walter Cronkite. And all my relatives in Florida can see me on TV. This was very exciting. There was also U.S. News and World Report ran a story about it. This was my connection between computing and sports when I was at Case. This was also a clever way for IBM to get advertisements in there rather subtly. It was when I first realized how hard it must be to be a movie star, because I had to walk through these scenes 6 times everything, you know, punch those cards over and over again. So I can see how could Audrey Hepburn possibly look so beautiful after the sixth take, you know?